Okay, here we've got some steel, mild steel that I just cleaned up a little bit with the 120 flap disc. And what we're going to do is demonstrate the new flame gel patina. Here I've got a bucket of copper FX and a bucket of clean water. I wanted to do the video inside so the road noise from the trucks going by and stuff wouldn't be a problem. So here we got a piece of fairly clean steel, still has some grinder dust on it. So what I'm going to do first is swish it in the water, leave it damp, blow off a little excess water, but still leave the steel damp. And I'm going to dip it in the copper and right back into the clean water. Now that copper has been neutralized and it should be good to go. So what we want to do now is, before that starts to flash rust, we want to get it completely dry. Wait for that compressor to kick off. Anytime now, Makita. This is the Flame FX that you're looking at. I'm going to show you the consistency by pouring it into this empty cup. You'll see that it's kind of thick, kind of like room temperature honey. And I'll put it back in here, trying to get an idea of what the viscosity is. I'm going to turn that compressor off because we're not going to need that much air for what we're doing in this demonstration. I don't even know if I've got everything centered in the viewfinder, but we'll call it good. Turn this compressor off so it won't be interrupting this again. Okay. There's a million different ways you could put the gel patina onto your steel, but I'm just going to take a little plastic spoon and take a little bit and drop it on there. You can see it instantly turns color, but rather than neutralize that and rinse it off, what you might want to do is drag the color into some different effects before you get... Let some of those effects be lighter than the other ones, for example. The longer it stays on, the darker it'll get. So let's neutralize that. And this is a little different than the spray patinas because you have to rub off that gel. It won't rub off the color, don't worry about that. But the gel itself needs to be rubbed off. So see, you've got kind of an interesting color pattern there. I don't know how well you can see that, but we're trying. Another thing I've had fun doing is, and it doesn't matter if you leave your steel wet at this point, but another thing I've done, let's take a fresh palette here. Just drop a little bit, say right there, and with very, very soft air, move it around, get different looks going. No, I that gel around, and the more that I splatter and move it around, the different patterns will emerge. And when the chemical is exhausted and nothing else happening, you can rinse that off and see what it looks like. Here you've got some interesting patterns that you would never get with just the spray patina. Not that that's a good or bad thing, but see this, it won't wipe off. Looks pretty cool, and you can do different things. You could darken it up a little bit in spots. You can always add to it. There again, no idea if I'm in the center of the frame, but let's take a little stick and just kind of move it around just a tad, just to darken up those spots where I put the second go around of Flame FX gel on the steel. And you can see that darkening up a little bit. The more you move it around, the more chemical you'll put in contact with the surface, and the more effects and darkening you'll get. So we'll clean that off. And you'll see that those spots appear now as a different color variation on what we first did. Here's the cool thing, and there's the first side we played with the brush. But here's the cool thing about Flame FX. We'll clean the grinding dust off of this steel. Leave the steel wet just to show you how it works. The cool thing about Flame FX is it will work on bare steel, where the Torch FX won't. So there again, we can play with it a little bit, get centered here. The more you move it around, the more variation of color depth, shadow, overlay, the more interesting your pattern will get, the more you move it around and play with it. Let's neutralize that and see what it looks like. Some interesting mauves and purples and blues. Not sure if you can see all that, but there's some really cool colors in there just with one product. And it's all based on how long the product is left, the gel is left on the steel. If you leave it there in one spot, like I am right now, in a concentrated way, it's going to get pretty dark. And if you work in the confines of that spot, just to move the chemicals around a little bit, it's going to get very dark. We'll move that around with a little bit of air just for fun. That. So I'm going to freeze that. I'm going to neutralize it and stop the chemical reaction right there because I like what it was doing. Sometimes if you go too long, you just wish you would have stopped it quicker. But if you can see in this area right here where I first put it on, and then as I push the chemical away from that original spot, how it develops some marbleizing, different tones and textures. And keep in mind, every color that you see on this sample piece of steel is all from one product, Flame FX gel. The Torch will do similar things on copper-plated steel, but this is not copper-plated. So again, we'll We'll just go halfway with the copper and neutralize it. So now we've got a sheet of steel that's left side is copper, right side is virgin steel. Take a little flame, and you'll see the difference of what it does on the two different surfaces. It helps if you don't stand on your arrows. Neutralize that, freeze the color action, as Turtle Man would say, live action. So what we've got here is a copper plated steel, plain steel, gel FX patina, flame FX gel patina has made these color bands and color variations on this piece of steel. So that's about it. I do have one little thing that's classified. One little thing I'm working on. And I'll just demonstrate it quickly to see what it does.